So here are the three laureates.
Well, it's very nice. Obviously, it's hugely prestigious. There's nothing more prestigious to a scientist than the Nobel. As nice as it is, what counts for me more is that we've been able to prevent millions of infections that otherwise would have occurred around the world through the blood supply. Having identified the virus and know what kind of virus it is and how it replicates, we were able to develop blood tests. So that happened within a couple of years or less. Then, of course, the next big priority was to develop therapeutics for Hep C. If it's left untreated over the course of many years, you can develop liver cirrhosis and liver cancer. And of course, those can be fatal. So 400,000 people today die of Hep C around the world, 400,000. Contrast that with 1 million people that have died from COVID so far this year. It took the academic field and the pharmaceutical industry about 20 years, just over 20 years, in fact, to develop really good drugs that we have available now. So these are safe, these are very effective, and they cure virtually all Hep C patients within 1 to 2 months. However, those drugs are very expensive, and in Canada, we have up to 12,000 new infections of Hep C every year. And because of the drug epidemic, the fentanyl epidemic and so forth, that number may well be growing. As is the case for any epidemic of a virus infection or a bacterial infection, to actually really stop the transmission, you need a vaccine. And that's what we're working on very hard. We're very optimistic that we have an improved vaccine to use against Hep C. At the University of Alberta, we're manufacturing it now under GMP, which is the standard required for testing it in clinical trials next year. You cannot stop an epidemic as large as Hep C or as COVID just with good therapy. You absolutely have to have a vaccine to really curb the transmission around the world. Getting prizes is very pleasant, very nice, but it's only prizes. I'm much more happy when we can actually intervene successfully in Hep C patients and preventing people from getting infected and curing them.